Did you ever want to link multiple records dynamically inside your Airtable account to another record? And you had been using Integromat for that and you receive this error is not a valid record ID because you had been mapping the values like this. Then this video is for you because I will show you a hack how you can make it work and fix this issue. Hey, my name is Manuel and I'm the founder of techflow.ai and we love automation. In this video, I will show you how you can have a little hack to use Airtable on Integromat and update one record to add multiple linked records to it. That was a long sentence, I'm sorry about that. But yeah, so let's show the issue first, what we have currently. So if you have like a linked record field and you want to add multiple records to it, you can either add items one by one, so by the record ID, or you can turn on the map field, which is usually used if you want to dynamically set the records that you want to infuse here. So it automatically formats it that way, but if we run it that way, then we will receive this error. Is not a valid record ID. So how can we fix that? We can fix that first by using the DevTool. I'm not sure if you've used the Integromat DevTool before. If you haven't, I really highly recommend that you check it out. Go to the Chrome Web Store and download the Integromat DevTool and then press F12 on Windows in your computer to get into the Integromat console. And then you have this live stream feature. And when you run a module now, you can see the underlying API call and you can analyze what's going wrong here. So let's check the first one first. So I ran this one here, which was working because I added the records individually. So when I open the request body, it shows like that. So that means, okay, the records got formatted as an array. And this was working. Now, the second one, this module over here, where it's just a comma separated list. So when I open it again to show it, it's just this. So I just turned on the mapping. I turned on the mapping on this one here. Let me demonstrate it to you again. So if I turn on the mapping here, it will look like this. So this is basically what I did. And then this API call got done. And if I check it, it actually formats the whole thing as one string. And that is why it's failing. And that is why the API is not accepting it, because it expects an array here and not a string of record IDs. Now, how can we fix that? There would be a possibility to add like the quotation marks in between, which I've already tried. So you just edit like this, and then theoretically the structure would be correct because it puts automatically a parenthesis quotation mark at the beginning and at the end, and then it would be a normal array again. But Integromat is smart, of course. It automatically escapes the quotation marks to make it a valid string, and that is how it looks like. It's still a string and it's still failing. So how can we do that? Now here's the little hack that you can use. And that is using the split function by splitting this list with a comma, or by the comma. And that will generate an array of the records here, the record IDs, and then it will work again. So this is the API call of this module. So then you will have the record IDs in the format that this module expects, and you can still map it. That means you can dynamically create a list of the records that you want to input here and that you want to record, link to this record. So let's say you have the Airtable module for search records. So you have the search records module, and then you want to get out like 10 records and you want to link them all to one single module. Then you have the array aggregator or text aggregator, for example, and can use that inside your module. And let's do this quickly. The easiest way is using the array aggregator. By the way, if you want to learn more about the iterator and aggregator, there's a link in this video. It will be over here, up there in the corner, where I have another tutorial specifically about iterators and aggregators, where you can learn more about how they work and how you can make use of them. So we use the search records at the source module, and then the target structure, we can use the second. Probably not allowing me to do that. So in that case, it actually doesn't work with the array aggregator because the format is something, or is kind of weird, which Airtable expects. So we will use the text aggregator module instead. So we add a module, it's the text aggregator, and then we create that module, we create that array ourselves. So the text aggregator, we use the search records else as source and use the ID here. If you click on advanced settings, you can add a row separator. We want to use other and put a comma in between. So let me show you the output quickly of that one. So run this once. Yes, it's a transformer, I don't mind. So we have this one here. And the output will be a list of all the records like we had it before, if we map it. And now we can use the same principle that we had before. So let me actually just duplicate the one that we had before and fill in the value of our text aggregator here. So instead of this list, we use the variable of our text aggregator like this and press OK and save it, run once. And oh yeah, okay, so it actually added the records of the same table, so that's not possible. And I will update that quickly and run it again. 1 second, please. So here we go. Now I've chosen another table and now it worked. So it successfully added all the new linked records to this one record. And that is how you can dynamically link a ton of different records to one record in Airtable and make the mapping field work by using the text aggregator and then using this small little hack with a split function over here. So I hope this was helpful. If you like this video, please hit the like button and comment below, and also subscribe to my channel for more tutorials on Integromat and learning more about Integromat in general and automation. Thank you very much for watching.